Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. We're not going to do a daily. We're not going to do a greed mode. We're going to do something normal. Let's just go Eden down to hard mode. See if we can kill a delirium. See what items we get. What is this straw? Also, we have Monster's Lung just straight out of the gate. Wait, what just happened? Did it hurt everything in the room? I have no idea what happened. It's like I'm drinking the walls. I've never seen this item before. Well, hey, at least it's a fun item in Monster's Lung. I don't know what that even did. I don't even know how much health I have. Which means I probably shouldn't be getting hit. What is this item? It doesn't seem to be hurting anything. Well, maybe it is. Proved me wrong. Just right out of the gate right there. Just proved me wrong. I have a straw sticking out of my head. It's a very deadly looking straw. Well, that's confirmed. We took red heart damage. Also, there's a tinted rock right there. That's good. Ah, giant champion explodey thing. Alright, we have a Wheel of Fortune card too, so we're gonna do this. We get two keys out of it and a bomb. I really have to wonder how this straw works. It recharges, but I think it only does damage if I have my damage charged, or maybe it's just always a very small amount of damage by design or something like that. I don't get it. We're gonna keep experimenting with this. Not like we have much other option. Hi. Locking me in the corner. This isn't bad. This is a decent synergy. I would like some tears up though. Definitely wouldn't mind some tears up. Look, this is taking a long time to charge. Yeah. I am happy, though, to have this just crazy amount of burst damage. Isn't this nice? I want to see how much damage this does. Oh, a heart came out of the wall. We're going very slow, by the way. Our speed through this level is just... It's so slow. Mostly because I don't know what the straw does. I don't know why it's doing such little damage. I mean, questioning why it's doing such little damage sort of implies that I know what it is in the first place, which would be a lie. There is no such implication. I should not make such an implication. Monster's Lung is something I'm safe with, though. I feel happy with Monster's Lung. I also feel happy with these Spirit Hearts, which help me know that I'm doing a good job and that I should not touch that. And that's a D1. I don't remember what you do. I don't know if I want to touch that. Rerolls the basics? I have no idea what happened. So, we're just gonna Ghost Pepper. All right. I think I'm happy with that. I think I'm happy having a Ghost Pepper in my life. Oh, look at that. It just comes out while I'm charging. How wonderful is that? What kind of crazy synergy? It'd be even better if I could, like, accidentally fire it in a direction that would help me. That was really nice, though. Alright, what do we got here? I'm drowsy. Accidentally killed that red dude in the corner. Yeah! I really need a tears up. There we go. Maybe we'll get something good out of our deal with the devil here. Maybe we'll kill Monstro really quickly. There's our tears up. A fame. Yeah. It's not the safest thing in the world to grab. But at the same time, it's not the worst thing in the world to grab. It at least guarantees deal with the devil instead of deal with the angels. Jeez. And also sometimes guarantees black hearts. So that's good. We got the infinite chests. Oh, Joker. Okay. Why did I say infinite chest? We have infinite key. It's a big difference. There's a big difference in the way these things work. The infinite chest is a thing that doesn't actually exist. Pin? The straw is very weird. I don't know if I like it. Time to just go ahead and blow that up. He says with a red heart right next to him, what's wrong with me? It was right there. It was just calling to me. Get out of here. Thanks for the key, sucker. Unfortunately, I do have an idea where the secret room is. Open. Now that I have a bomb, I can test this theory. In fact, I don't think it's there now that I see the bomb mark on the floor. Which is really confusing, because it looks like it really should be there. More options? Here we go! On to the next floor! Our time sucks. 7 minutes. You know what? Worst things have happened in the Binding of Isaac land. Like, oh my god. That was a room full of life. The likes of which I'll probably never see again. That was horrifying! The straw killed it and set off a chain reaction that I was not expecting. Ooh, the straw can one-shot these dudes, these little poopers. These little pooplers. I like saying poop. Get out of here. Get out of here. I'm gonna try this room and then regret everything. Maybe not everything. Let's see if we can find a way out before we hurt ourselves again. I didn't think it was likely. There's hearts everywhere. It's ridiculous. A challenge room. Oh my god. I don't know. I think I kind of like the straw. Though, I wish it would charge just a little bit faster. Uh, Like, with it being so weak and charging as slow as it does, it kind of contradicts itself in a way. It's like, why do I want it? I can just drink. Drink from the room, and then nothing happens. That's just what's happening most of the time. Nothing. That did not feel very good. Well, here's me being almost dead. Almost getting hit by a bat. Good God, man. Thank you, Athame. I wonder if it scales based on my tier damage. Which is painfully average right now. If I get more damage, will that help me? Will that help me drink harder? I forgot item rooms are a thing in this. These both suck. GB bug is not or undefined. Oh crap. Yeah, they both suck. It's the reality of it. We might as well go into the shop too. I mean, it's right there. We have plenty of keys. Gonna buy that. Probably should have donated a couple of money to the money machine. Oh, jeez. This is a horrible, horrible room to have these dudes in. I killed it! Please. Just... these guys won't die. This is horrible. So this straw sometimes creates a heart. It's kind of weird. That actually did a somewhat decent chunk of damage. Color me impressed. I'm beginning to have a newfound respect for this innocuous-seeming item. A seemingly innocuous item. Alright, we're gonna grab this and we're gonna go teleport.
Joker.
Wait, that's an angel. Why is there an angel here? That's peculiar. Ah! Please, it's not flying out of my fires. It's too smart for me. It's dodging them like a pro! Alright, a nickel. Uh-huh. Cool. A nickel. For all that work, you give me a nickel. Look. Normally I would explore this floor more. Because there's a whole direction that I haven't gone, but I hate not having my map. And we got a rune bag. Which immediately makes everything better. Dude, this drinking straw actually can probably synergize very nicely with Dark Bum. Dark Bum Friend. Dark Bum Friend will save our lives. Sister Maggie with the killing blow! Unprecedented levels of... I don't even know what word to assign that. That was very unexpected. That was a reward that I really wasn't expecting at that very particular moment. It gave me half a soul heart. I guess maybe it felt sorry for me for not having any red hearts, or maybe it just... I mean, I guess that's kind of what it means. Blank rune. Hey, nice. Probably shouldn't have done that. Shouldn't have done that. Reminds me of Hagrid. Okay, the worst thing about Monster's Lung and the Ghost Peppers is Ghost Peppers will actually stop my Monster's Lung. The fire collides with the fire. Not the best situation. And dead. Alright. There are a few things I would like to see here to make me a little more okay with this run. First, I would like to see more damage. I think my tier rate is fine. I think we can be reasonably pleased with how our DPS is looking. A Thame would be awesome. Not a Thame. Maw of the Void. Maw of the Void would be incredible to have right now. The Frail. Oh, God. Yeah, Maw of the Void would be absolutely wondrous to have. Maw of the Void. Eek. I don't think I want that. I think I'm happy with my drinking straw. It seems to be getting better and better deeper in that I go. So I think I'm happy with this drinking straw. We're gonna hold on to it. We're gonna go find our item room as well. And I know this is supposed to be a run that goes eventually to Delirium, but I don't know. What was that? Was that another Dagaz? But I don't know if I'm comfortable with Monster's Lung. I'm going deeper. You know what I mean? Monster's Lung doesn't really seem like a very good Delirium fighter, you know? However, that a Thame could be very, very, very beneficial. We'll have to see how things pan out. We'll also have to see how this is gonna take us. Oh, look at those bombs, boy. Look at those bombs. Didn't expect that. Gonna create a bridge. We're gonna create another bridge. Monkey's paw. I have no idea what that does. So yeah, let's just grab it, I guess. Wish granted. What is my wish? What wish did I make? I have a feeling that I should have hit that while those little dudes were bopping around. I could have possibly gotten a black heart out of them. Let's grab this black candle because curses suck. I don't need to grab that red heart. I can find red hearts basically anywhere. Like right there. There was that one room on the previous floor with like 50 of them just for free. Also, how kind is that? And that. Just giving me all sorts of goodies. Oh. I almost took that shot. This guy needs to die. Like, for real. Just die. What decides whether or not a void gets destroyed by its own monster spawning tendencies? That's something I haven't been able to figure out yet. Man, Ghost Pepper helping me out before I could even realize. Oh boy. Yeah. I would have liked to hold on to the straw. Let's be real here. If delirium is our end-all be-all, if delirium is our final goal, we've really got to make sure that we get every chance to actually go down there. Dad's key will open Megastan's door for us. And that on its own. That on its own is going to be worth getting rid of the drinking straw. I would have liked to explore that item a little more. I would have liked to see where it would take us. Actually, I can't get cursed. I might as well just pop that and take the Empress with me. So, I hate leaving behind that drinking straw. I miss it already. That's not it. That goes down. Secret room? Nice. Tears up, please. I'd accept a speed up as well, considering how awful that room was. 5 different pills, and not one of them was positive. A few of them were neutral, like damage dealing pills, but overall, that was not a good set of pills. I miss my drinking straw. Just the ability to shave health off of these things. Just would be really nice, considering their movement patterns. But hey, you can't... Beggars can't be choosers, right? Isaac's definitely a beggar. He's just taking anything that he finds, just laying on the ground. There's that reroll thing again. Still don't know why or what its purpose is. Don't you hop on me. It hopped on me. I let it hurt me. Perthrow would be nice. See if we'll get anything that's actually worth perthrowing. Alright, this is the bad thing about Monster's Lung. Oh my god, okay. Oh jeez. Not doing well. Monster's Lung is proving to be more of a distraction than anything. What do we got here? Yara? Perthrow the Yara. Suckers. Did not expect that one. Did not expect that specific hand of mom. So overall, this run is turning out to be a little bit of a crapshoot overall. And by crapshoot, I mean my ability to aim at anything. Anywhere. D100 could be amazing. No. We're gonna go vanilla for this. Mama Mega. Sure. It's gonna be a little obnoxious from here on out. Hope you don't mind. So yeah, that's gonna keep happening.
Degas.
I could have Yera'd that room. I completely forgot that I had Yera. These guys didn't die? Jerkwads. Oh jeez, that almost got me. Troll bomb. Man, that second secret room is always just like... It's either a troll... Or just like, incredible. Our time really sucks. Dank depths 1. Get out of here. Alges. Huh. Alges, definitely a rune that we want to take all the way to the end of the game. I would go so far as to say that Alges is the best consumable that exists in the Binding of Isaac, period.
Pheromones.
I mean, there's really not... I don't think there's anything that's better than it. I probably should have Yera'd that Degas. Give me an extra soul heart, because I'm definitely taking that Alges with me. It's like... It's a huge amount of invulnerability. Like, you can't just take that. You can't just leave that behind. Why would you do such a thing? You wouldn't. That's what. Actually, we might have something to Yera here. Depending on how lucky or unlucky we get. That's pretty unlucky. Fine, we'll just take the Alges and we'll get out. You happy? Take the Alges and leave. Actually, got one more possibility for good stuff. The world. Nope, taking the Alges. I haven't fought the boss yet. I didn't realize that. And got him. And got him. And got him. Get out of here. Get out of here, Monstro. Oh! You'd think I was baiting it. Nope. No deal with the devil. You'd think I would be baiting him, but I guess I wasn't. He was more clever than I. Range down. Fantastic. What is this? What do we got? I should have perthrowed the box. Why didn't I think to perthrow the box? Whatever. Whatever, we'll just go down. Next floor. Let's go. Cannot go in there. Unless I can. Ha! Not worth it. With two charge on this key, there's... It's not a waste. You're a waste. Your face is a waste. Man, my coworkers have gotten that insult stuck in my head. Say something like a little like abnormal. And then they say, your face is abnormal. Oh, no. They don't say it like that. They say, your face is abnormal. Yeah, it's like that slight amount of contempt, you know? That just little bit amount to make you know that they're joking, but at the same time, they want to... What's the word I'm looking for? It's the best word for this. They want to say, I don't fully agree with what you're saying. Except I don't think they mean it like that. They have nothing else to really add, so they add that. I mean, sometimes that's how conversations go, right? I wouldn't know. I don't get in conversations. I'm antisocial. Okay, I'm not antisocial. That's a little bit of a... exaggeration, a little bit of hyperbole. If you don't mind me indulging in a little bit of larger words, a few larger words. Man, sometimes I'm eloquent. Most of the times I'm not. Well, that did not work out for me. There's a diaper. We're gonna steal some money from you. This gives me double items, double item options on boss rooms. Which will definitely come in handy, you son of a jerk. I don't know why I did that. This room literally cannot have a secret room in it. Don't know what I was thinking. Oh, there's three pins in this room. Why wouldn't there be? Alright, one pin down. Okay, hi. I didn't realize it, but I picked up a dark bum with my Cambian Conception. Cambian Conception is that, like, little red stomach item that I have on the right side. I'm sure it's supposed to be a fetus or something. But to me, it's always looked like a stomach. Maybe it's a uterus. I don't know. It's called Conception. Cambian Conception. So, I mean, it makes sense that it's a uterus, perhaps. But you take a certain amount of red heart damage, boom, you get a familiar for free. Another Yara. Have I found the item room in here yet? We're gonna get that Alges on our way back. Did you just drop a spider for me? Thanks, man. Yeah. Okay. Alright. I don't know where all these red hearts are coming from. Oh, it's probably Sister Maggie. Sister Maggie's probably doing good work for me. There you go. Little dark bum friend. I wonder what we got in here. Huh. What do we got? A room full of batteries. Use the key 5 times in the same room. What if I just, like, completely screwed up some super secret, some super, super duper secret unlock ability? Like, maybe using Dad's key 5 times in the same room is actually a way to unlock something in The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. I highly doubt it. But I don't know if any of you were around for the original way to unlock the Lost. It was horribly, horribly convoluted.
Answers.
Like, I don't like to look up solutions for things. But, like, I could not unlock the Lost without a guide. I couldn't. It was so ridiculously convoluted. This is awful. Ghost Pepper just saved him for a long time. A dunce cap. Also, I'm gonna come in here. Gonna bomb these open. What are these? Was not expecting 2 cards. Judgment?
Judgment.
All right. I want my keys. I feel blessed. It's okay, guys. I feel blessed. Oh, no. And this is around the time I use my Yara card. Check that out. Also, Gimpy is just being a bro right now. The little mask thing that I went and picked up earlier. Gives me a chance to get one of these little blue hearts every time I get hurt. And these sacrifice rooms. If only I had been able to save my year for this moment. I have so much cash. That was awful. That was awful as well. But whatever, we made it, and we can give this guy all the cash in the world. Please drop something good. I said good. But at least you dropped something. I can't really fault you too much. So, time to go all the way back to the boss. Wait. Shop first. This is Dank Depths 2. There's nothing good in here. So I'm just gonna donate to that as much as it'll let me, and then I guess grab a bomb and a key on the way out. What else am I gonna spend it on? We're about to go into the womb. The place where money cannot be spent. And we'll pop this open. Not grab the tick. Because I will never be able to get rid of it. I'm going to go back, grab the battery. Because I want to see if this will let me into the boss rush room. I doubt that it will, but if it does, that'd be very interesting. Because then it would also mean that it would let me into the hush fight. Maybe. That's a lot of dudes. It's a whole lot of dudes. It's a whole lot of dudes. Also, monsters along with this parasite? Kinda nice. Look at all the good stuff I'm getting. I'm gonna grab this. You have anything for me, friend? Nope. And that does not let me into the boss rush room. I didn't expect it to, but you know what? Crazier things have happened in the Binding of Isaac. Utero 1. Man. I've been so congested all day. Allergy season is the worst. It's just, it's the absolute worst. Thanks for the spider, the unhelpful spider. Allergy season is just the worst. Like, seriously, it's... Growing up, I never had allergies. And then one day life was, it just decided to be like, hey. Hope you didn't like breathing. You're not gonna do that ever again. And the worst thing about it is that I didn't start developing allergies. Well, I mean, it was a little before I started having an interest in YouTube and voice acting that I started developing these allergies. And that my congestion, which I've had my whole life, honestly, just started to get worse and worse. I've always had bad sinuses, you know. I'm sure it's something that a lot of people can relate to. I mean, I feel like more people can relate to having bad allergies or like chronic congestion or just chronically bad sinuses than can relate to having a wonderful nose, a wonderful, helpful, beautiful nose. Not many people can relate to that. At least I don't think so. I certainly can't. But the moments that I have where I can actually breathe through my nose correctly, and it just, the air comes in and it goes out, and it's just, and that's it. No questions asked. It's a wonderful, wonderful feeling. It's almost euphoric. Almost. But it's a feeling that's easy to miss. Like, if you have a day, if you have a really good day and you could just... You can breathe. You just feel it that much more the next day. That was not good. You just feel it that much more the next day, you know? It's like, oh man, I could breathe yesterday. Now I'm all stopped up. Tears up! Hell yeah. Hello, fistula. Nice to see you in here. Speed down? I don't think so. Range down? Why do you do this to me? What's up, Loki? There's so many hearts flying around. It's great. What did I do to deserve all this wonderful love? Look at that. Things are dying and hearts are just popping out of nowhere. Got any hearts for me, friend? There's one. All right. I'll accept you. Another one. Normally I wouldn't bother with the money. Serious? Oh wait, I'm full. Normally I wouldn't bother with the money. What am I saying? There's no way I'm gonna be able to get down to Hush. We're at 38 minutes. And we're in Utero 1. Answers. The library down there. Let's go visit it. There's a secret room in this room. Let's open it up. It's not in this room. Whoops. Monstrous Lung with this parasite. I think I already said this. It's a very good synergy that I'm actually liking quite a bit. Look at all these spiders I have now. All these spiders and flies. This is wonderful. Get out of here. Telepathy. Just gonna pick it up in case we find more books later on. I accidentally burned that dude. Sorry. I didn't mean to murder you. It just kind of happened, you know? I didn't mean nothing by it. I swear. Whoops. Questioning of the day. Since I only do these whenever I can. What? What hit me? I only do these when I can actually think of a question to ask. And I thought of one. Just because I have this just awful, awful urge to go back and watch Hunter x Hunter again. I say awful because I don't have the time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. 2 health up. Give me the one that'll give me a trinket. Unfortunately, it's not the most helpful of deals with the devil, but it's okay. I don't need to lose all my red hearts. I have this horrible urge to rewatch all of Hunter x Hunter, and I only say horrible because, like I said, I don't have any time to watch 100 and... What is it, 15 episodes? Maybe 150-something? I don't remember exactly how many. But I really want to go and rewatch that anime. It's my favorite anime of all time. It's been my favorite anime of all time. This is a very familiar start to this floor, by the way. These rooms all look the same. It's my favorite anime. I love that show so much. It's so good. It's so fantastic. And I want to watch it, but I can't. I mean, I could. It's not like I'm not currently watching Iron Fist on Netflix. In fact, I almost watched the whole thing over the weekend. And here I am saying that I can't afford to spend the time on it. Pfft. Man, you watching Iron Fist all weekend. Maybe not all weekend. Another library. This is going to get us Spore Eyes. Or Bookworm. Like, super easily. Son of a nugget. I mean, watching something new, I guess, is different than watching something that you've seen before. that you're just rewatching for nostalgic reasons, and because it's a damn good show. But you know what I mean. I like to focus more on absorbing new experiences. That's why I like playing indie games, and that's one of the reasons I started my channel in the first place, was so I could share my love for exploring all these new indie games. And while my channel focus has kind of shifted away from that, in a sense, I found a pretty neat way, in my opinion, to maybe not, like, continue down that path, because the way I show games now is a lot more targeted than it was before. I'm sure some of you miss my yet another first impression series. In a way, I kind of miss doing them. It took a lot of time, though. And as I spend more and more time coming up with more and more higher quality content for my main channel, it's just like, I can't afford the time anymore. And there were so many times when I would just, for the sake of having something for my schedule, I would just scramble for some random game on Steam and then give it some admittedly somewhat half-assed impression. That exploded a lot quicker than I was expecting. It was fun trying all those new games. But I think eventually it would have gotten really old really quickly. I don't even know why I'm like telling you guys all this. You don't care about all the inner workings of my channel. So this is all stuff that I've said anyway in the past. I mean, if you know my Yet Another First Impression series, you probably know why I don't do them anymore. Anyway, on to happier, bluer pastures, greener textures, and other things. One of these days I would like to do a Lawbreakers video. Just because all of my success today is because of that Paladins versus Overwatch versus Battleborn video. Without that video, most of you probably wouldn't even be watching me. I mean, I literally only had there's nothing worth going back for. I literally only had like 380 subscribers whenever I released that video. And I released that video and that got me to like 5,000 or 6,000 because it went viral. Sometimes YouTube's about luck, man. And that's okay. Sometimes it's just about, it's not about luck, and it's about just kicking ass and doing your best and putting out good content and finding a good niche that hasn't been filled yet for that content. It's a combination of all of these things. I'm gonna go back and get this spirit heart because I'm actually a little low. Also, if you haven't been able to tell, I've a little bit run out of things to talk about here. This is not one of my most conversational days. I've had more conversational days. This hasn't been my most verbally eloquent day either. I'd like to blame it on my congestion. It all goes back to the congestion. It's almost like humans need to breathe, and without being able to breathe, they perform worse. Ooh, almost got hit by that. Where is... Well, alright. I believe that's only our first guppy item. Did you just pop out of the portal? That didn't feel good. This portal's not dead. How did that even happen? Get out of here, ghost. Jeez. Have to try it. A gold chest is too good to not try to open. I could just escape. And I probably should have, but it's a little too late now. I mean, we're already, like, deep in the thick of this. This is the last boss of this room, so might as well. Might as well just kill him and go on with our lives. Ansa's? Perthro. No reason to take that with us. I mean, we probably won't even get an item. And now, for some reason, my nostalgia brain is going right back to the Burning Crusade, World of Warcraft, the Burning Crusade. Why? What is my brain doing right now? Maybe it's because I don't want to go to work tomorrow. I just want to keep making videos for you guys forever, you know? I have so many ideas, and not enough time to execute them all. But if I had the time to execute all my ideas, would I still have ideas? That's the scary part. Like, if I actually did have the ability to quit my job. If I did have the means to quit my job and pursue YouTube and voice acting full time, would I be able to maintain a level of content to stay relevant? And I know there's a handful of people who would say, oh, I'd watch you forever. And I appreciate that. I appreciate that a lot. The sun. But as far as staying relevant goes, like, if you're relying on YouTube for a main source of income, you have to stay relevant. Otherwise, I don't know why that didn't hit the wall, but we'll just pop that open. If you don't stay relevant, what do you got? What? I'm also just now realizing that I don't even need Dad's key anymore. I've been carrying this around for no reason, because I have the key for the door. I actually have the actual key, and I've been carrying the stupid thing around the whole time. Oh boy. I mean, I guess it saves me bombs. But yeah, if it's a full-time job, you gotta make sure you maintain ideas, you maintain relevancy, you stay entertaining. And honestly, the idea stresses me out. Like, I'm stressed out already. Every time I release a video and I get, like, less than 1,000 views now, I used to be thrilled with 100. But if I get less than 1,000 now, I'm just like, oh man, what did I do wrong? Like my Pokemon video. I thought it was amazing. Not a lot of people tuned into it. But you know what? Them's the breaks of YouTube. That's the highs and lows, you know? Still a fly in this room. I have a lot of spiders floating around.
AWAS.
There's another. Oh, that wasn't a heart, that was a spider. See how I can get those confused. As much as I want it, the idea of YouTube full time scares the hell out of me. The idea of voice acting and YouTubing as like a dual full-time job scares the living hell out of me. Will I actually make it to that point? I don't know, maybe. Whether I do or not, YouTube's a lot of fun, I enjoy it. In spite of how stressful it is, it's the stress that makes it fun for me, I think. Without the stress, it's nothing. The stress means I care about it. I'm not doing this just for the money. And me wanting to do it full time, me wanting to be able to make the money to do it full time, is not about the money. It's about just doing what I find, doing what I want with my life. That's all anybody could ever want, is to do what they want. That sounds stupid. Sounds really stupid when you say, when you put it that way. All anybody could ever want with their life is to just, is just do what they want. But you know, these all suck, like really badly. This one's better. But these all suck. Oh, Monster Manual, I guess. I would love a Perthrow now. What was that going on about? I was just rambling. If I didn't have the stress, then I think it would mean that I didn't care. And the reason I do this, even though it stresses me out, is because A, I love it. And the reason I, well, there's no B. I do it because I love it. You know? I love games. I love playing games. I love talking about games. I love sharing games. I love games. And it's not just about the games either. I mean, everybody pretty much wants to be a YouTube personality, right? It's just like, hey, I want to be a YouTube personality. I could be a YouTube personality. All I have to do is play games for a living. It's more than that. It's a lot more than that. Is this a walnut? I don't know what that is. It seems like it's just playing games for a living. But for me, it's about more than the games. It's about entertaining people. It's about making people laugh or smile or have a good time or just simply being an avenue with which to kill time. A source of entertainment. To be able to let people enjoy their time just a little bit better. That's what I've wanted ever since high school. Somehow I ended up in computer science. Which, don't get me wrong, I enjoy very much. AWOS, this probably goes nowhere. This is probably not a secret room. Yeah, I started as an art major, and I realized I didn't quite have the talent for drawing or anything like that. So I went towards what I did have talent for. The animation part, it was really because I wanted to either work at Pixar or work as an animator for game development. I thought I had this guy already. Like a 3D animator is what I wanted. And it was all for the means of entertaining. And if I did manage to achieve that goal, like, I don't think I would have ever started this YouTube channel. So, I mean, even though I'm not in game development, and I'm not an animator, and my career currently does not revolve around entertainment, without being where I am now, I probably never would have had the incentive to start this channel. Not incentive, the motivation, the drive, a reason to start this channel. Or both my channels, I guess. Still no void, so we're gonna go all throughout this chest, clear it out. and hope desperately that we can get a void to spawn at the end of Megastan. So yeah, there's my life story. Episode's not over yet. We're at 55 minutes in. There's lots of money on the ground. I'm not going to pick any of that up. We're already at 99 anyway. Not like it matters. I forgot I left a lot of hearts in here. I saw that there was one. I didn't realize I left more than one. I want to go back and get my Alge's rune back. I can't believe I just left that on the floor. Hagalaz, you're going to be used for nothing. Just for that. Just for forcing me to take you with you. Take you with me. But yeah, I hope there's no more frame drops. This is the third episode in a row since tweaking my settings. So far, so good. I'm paranoid now, of course. See what I mean? It's like, the stresses come from just minor things. I mean, it seems like it's minor. But to me, it doesn't feel minor. I mean, those imperfect episodes with those frame drops, those are on YouTube forever. They're there forever now. And because of those frame drops, the entertainment that I've created is a little bit less entertaining. About maintaining a consistent level of quality control, so to speak. Oh jeez. I don't know. Like I said, I'm just kind of rambling at this point. And don't worry about me. Just in case there's anybody who's like, oh, Alex, you don't need to do all this stuff. You take care of you. Take some time off if you need to. Don't get hit by brimstone, you scrub. And we'll be here when you get back. And I appreciate that, but I'm not so stressed that it's like affecting my health. I'm not Gerard levels of stressed. Gerard Khalil, the completionist, his levels of stress are ridiculous. Like, what he puts himself through, the man's insane. It's like, oh, let's complete Skyrim. That sounds like a good idea. No, Gerard, that's not a good idea. What is wrong with you? But it's for the channel. But he does it because he loves it. It's all about the love, the passion. He wouldn't be doing it if he wasn't enjoying it. He could probably get a more stable wage doing other things. Maybe, I don't know. I don't know how much his channel makes. Significantly more than mine, for sure. But yeah, I mean, he wouldn't... That goes for pretty much every YouTuber that exists. I say pretty much, because clearly not every YouTuber is so altruistic that their goal is to entertain and be passionate. There are the exploitative ones who are really literally just in it for the money and nothing else. There are YouTubers like that. And shame on them. Shame on them. It's about YouTube, not DollarTube. Yeah, that's what I like about YouTube. That's what I appreciate the most. Out of not just my involvement in it, but just the fact that even if indirectly, I'm part of this group of creators. This group of entrepreneurs. Who are just kind of sharing things. Sharing things that make them happy. And making other people happy by doing that. just something awesome about that, you know? Every once in a while, we get a little existential here on Ingenious Clown Let's Plays. Some may say pretentious. I mean, this is the inside of my head. This is what goes on inside. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. And that's the floor cleared. There's another. Nope. We got no Perthrow. None. Not a single one. Disappointed. So we're just gonna go fight Megastan, pop our monster manual. And we got a Robo Baby. Jane, it's not so bad. I'm like doing real bad now. Alright. We could be doing better, but at the same time we could be doing worse. I'm not displeased right now. I have taken stupid damage already. But our Dark Bump Friend is gonna, he's just gonna have a good old time. Look at all this good stuff that he has to eat. And I'm summoning spiders and flies with the power of my pestilence. Not my pestilence, but my, my parasites. There we go. That's a much better word anyway. Parasites? It's a good word. The only thing that can make this more broken is Nodleaf. Although, even with Nodleaf, I don't think I could actually do anything with Nodleaf. I think I have to kill things for the hearts to come out. Oh no! Get out of here with your... Hello. Your stupid laser beams. I haven't killed a single hand yet. Still no single hand. Kill it. Dead. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. You know, even if we don't... Yeah, there's a dead hand. Even if we don't get a void here, I'm happy with this run. What the... Where did you guys come from? I'm pretty happy with this run in general. Just because it's been so long since I've really had a good run with Monstro's Lung. So I appreciate the fact that the game gave it to me. I would have appreciated a total victory more, but you know what? Beggars can't be choosers. I would have also appreciated a little more of a DPS increase. A damage increase. Because we've kind of been stuck with this pretty much most of the game. It's taking me so long to kill him. Dead? There we go. Where's the void? Where's the void? Where's the void? Where's the void? There it is! Holy crap, I wasn't actually expecting this to happen! It's been a long time coming. We're finally here. Let's go! Let's go! This is wonderful, and we got a Degas. Not that we need it right now, but it's there for when we do. Tinted Rock? No Tinted Rock. I don't think I'm going... Oh, man. I was afraid of that. Have I seen this pill? I haven't.
I guess I'm gonna go back and get that Degas now.
Degas. There we go. Was that a Tinted Rock? Normally, I would fully explore this floor. But, I mean, come on. This has already been an hour and 5 minutes. I haven't had much to say other than this, like, sappy nonsense. Everybody just needs to be happy, you know? That stuff. I'm not picking that up. It's gonna ruin my alges. If there's anything that I don't want out of this run, it's for my alges to be ruined. Don't ruin a man's alges. I ran over the red poop. That's what happened, isn't it? I hate these things. So we're just gonna go into these boss doors. You know. This is my own fault. But like, how's that for bad luck, huh? It's the first one. It's the first one. I just hope that we get hearts. I hope that he spawns something for me to kill, so I can get hearts. If I could actually, oh my god. And if I could get, like, a little tanky with all this, that'd be wonderful, too. Did it kill the skull? Did any hearts drop at all? I think I heard one. Oh, hi, Dingle. Yeah, there's a heart right there. There's... Ace of clubs? I don't think so. You think I need bombs right now? No. That's not what I need. Okay, I really don't appreciate the fact that that eyeball has been spawned right there in the corner. It's hard for me to reach. I gotta make sure I don't pick up that stupid, Ace of clubs. I don't need to convert everything. Absolutely not. I should have at least entered this room with a full charge of my of my monster manual. What was I thinking? Coming in here without a full charge of my item. This is a joke. It's a joke. What? Alright, that wasn't even fair. Alright, what just hit me there? I'm confused now. Alright, I know what hit me on that one. That was just me being bad. Why does it turn into, like, such low health? Whenever it turns into that little boo form. Obviously, you can't just kill him when he's like that. Oh, please don't turn into this dual boss ever again. Ow. Oh, explosions. I have very low health. I don't think this is going to be a win. It's not nearly as heartbreaking as the previous near win. Oh. Okay, so this is interesting. Damn it. Well, he picked up the heart. I didn't really want him to. I want it. I need it for myself now at this point. I'm gonna leave that blue heart on the ground for as long as I possibly can. Oh, jeez. He's starting to get faster. He's starting to get unmanageably faster. I Double Monstro across the sky. Why? Why did I say that? Wait a minute. You're just a normal ow. Oh my god. I have to pick that up. All right. Great. Give me that. I need that more than you. Why are there so many of these guys? Holy crap. What's going on? Why are there so many of these horseman bosses just kind of spawning out of nowhere? I do not understand. I'm scared now. No. All right, this is what the heck. Oh my god. He's gonna teleport, and there's gonna be friggin' laser beams from the sky, or not. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Delirium, you need to stop. It's time to stop. We need H3 in on this. We need Leonard French, your favorite copyright attorney. Ah! That's just stupid. I was doing so good actually avoiding everything. And then it's just freaking 100% absolutely unavoidable nonsense right there. Oh, there it is. All right, guys. It was almost close. I almost had hope. Here's our seed. 2WVLAWWW. As in, aw, he thought he was gonna make it. I didn't. I died. I was Lazarus anyway. And Have I beaten him as Lazarus? Yes. So it wouldn't have been a real victory anyway. We still need to beat him as Eve too. Jeez. Does this count? It's like it's got its own post-it note. Does it actually count? Whatever. I'll look that up. But I hope you enjoyed it. In spite of my blabbering. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.